So I'm preparing tomorrow to tell my students something about Chinese room and to walk them through this thought experiment that Searle was offering for everyone to consider. And I am kind of having this moment of wanting to critique it, and I might not be able to do it in class because, you know, for the lack of time, and I will rather maybe ask them what they think about it. But I'm just thinking that there are two things that do not sit really well with me with that experiment. The first one is that I think it doesn't take into account like how the actual language functions, because there is really no practical, real, technical possibility to give you really the rules of how to communicate, how to coordinate these scribbles in Chinese that is indistinguishable for Searle from the Japanese writing or from meaningless stuff, right? There is really no way to give the instructions in English so that the output of the speaker is indistinguishable from the output of the native speaker in Chinese when he's asked about understanding those stories. Like, there is no way you could really give this kind of instructions. You could really invent such program. So basically Searle is giving us a box within a box. Like, there is literally everything that you could imagine can go there, and it has no practical or real implications because it's pure fantasy. And the second objection that I have here is that this experiment doesn't seem to be taking into consideration the learning moment that Alan Turing was taking into consideration in his ideas, right? He was talking about children robots, child robot who is able to learn. So chances are that if your intellect is enough to be locked into this room, understanding those stories with the badge or whatever, to the point where when your output is indistinguishable from the output of the native speaker of Chinese, then chances are that you will learn what those scribbles mean, given that you have those instructions. You will learn inevitably something. So effectively, after this experiment, you would not be able to really say, as Searle does, I don't speak a word of Chinese. Because effectively, even within the framework of this experiment, he is exactly speaking Chinese, effectively. Because the output is indistinguishable from the output of the native speaker. So in what way does he not speak Chinese then after this experiment? In the way of how he feels about the language, but it's okay. We don't feel a non-native language just as we feel our native language. That's fine. So what is really happening in our brain that we think is so principally different from what the machine is doing then? Yeah, so I feel like this experiment is a little bit of Ouroboros and biting its own tail. You know, what is really distinguishes the agent here from the program? The agent's own idea that he doesn't understand the Chinese, even though effectively he is communicating in a way it is indistinguishable from the native speaker. In Chinese? Like what? But you are not the final authority on even saying, of even evaluating how well or bad you speak Chinese if you effectively give answers indistinguishable from the answers of the native speaker of Chinese. Right? or not.